Patch 9.22 just hit the live servers, and this one is a really special one since it is the last patch of the season. I want to quickly remind you that the ranked season ends on November 19th at midnight. Now, this doesn't mean that Riot is going to reset ranked at November 19th, at least they never have in the past. You're still going to keep your ranked throughout preseason and be able to climb during preseason as well, and then once the preseason is over, then they will reset ranks. This is, however, the checkmark for the end of season rewards, and if you want that Victoria skin, you're going to have to be in gold or higher by November 19th. Since there is only a few weeks left in the regular ranked season, we wanted to go over some of the picks that you can use right away in order to climb quickly. These picks won't take a whole lot of practice in order to perform well on, and they should be able to help you make that end of season push to get whatever it is your goal is. Now, if you are wanting something on top of these picks, then make sure to head over to our website, GameLeap.com. There, we have hundreds of guides, all done by Challenger players, sorted into a quick and easy to use courses system. We have courses both on the five fundamental roles as well as champion specific courses. So if that is something that interests you, then make sure to check us out using the link in the description below. Now, without further ado, let's get right into those picks, starting of course with the top lane. Now for top lane, there are two picks that are head and shoulders above the rest at the moment. The first of these two is going to be Garen. Ever since the mini rework that they gave to Garen, he's been absolutely dominating across all elos. He is not hard to play at all, his skill floor is one of the lowest in the entire game, and on top of that, he exerts insane amounts of pressure in the laning phase. He really only needs one offensive item in Triforce in order to be able to deal with most champions, and then he's able to go full tank afterwards. This makes him a massive threat in the mid to late game, especially if the enemy team has little to no true damage. His natural resistances that he gets from W helps make him especially tanky when he only has offensive items in the mid game, meaning there are absolutely no stages of the game in which Garen is especially weak. If you aren't already abusing Garen for easy elo, then you need to start, because this champion is absolutely bonkers right now, and he's not going to be getting nerfed before the season ends. The other top lane candidate is going to be Kayle. Now, Kayle is going to be a little bit harder to play than Garen, but she's still relatively easy. Kayle's biggest weakness is pre-level 6 when she's still melee, because she's not going to be able to get every single CS, and there are going to be some lanes that are going to counter her and destroy her, like Pantheon, for example. For this reason, I try not to blind pick Kayle whenever possible. Kayle is, however, probably one of the best picks in the entire game to play into tanks. She has hybrid damage, and once she hits level 6, she's just going to be farming Klepto stacks off of tanks, and she's going to get so much gold, let me tell you. In most games as Kayle, you're going to be getting at least 2 kills worth of gold from Klepto, as long as you are farming it properly. However, I have seen as much as 1500 gold in one game from Klepto. That's half of an item. Once Kayle gets 2 items and hits level 11, she becomes very scary, especially in teamfight scenarios. She is really hard to dive due to the move speed and her ult, while still doing insane amounts of damage and shredding armor, meaning there aren't very many picks that can deal with Kayle past that point. If the game does go to level 16 and full build, as Kayle, you're pretty much guaranteed to win, as there aren't very many champions that have as strong of a late game as a full build max level Kayle. The key thing with Kayle is to make sure that you're taking bone plating secondary if you are into a hard matchup. Remember that pre-level 6 is her weakest point, so you want to make sure that you're not dying at that point. Now, moving on into the jungle role, there's only a few things that we really need to focus on when playing jungle. This is that the champion needs to clear the jungle quickly and in a healthy manner, and they have to have good ganks. You also want to have it so that you can perform ganks frequently and you don't have to rely on one huge cooldown like your ultimate or your flash. For this reason, my jungle picks are going to be Hecarim and Warwick. Now, both of these champions are strong for pretty much the same reasons. They clear very quickly and very healthily, meaning they are not at all susceptible to any invades that might happen. Their ganks are really strong even before level 6, just using their basic abilities, and will oftentimes result in a kill, especially if the enemy laner is going to be low. Warwick specifically thrives on chasing down targets that are really low and executing them. In some games, you might not be able to use your blood scent all that much in order to run down enemy champions, but in some games, you might end up having 5 kills in the first 10 minutes from it. Another reason why Warwick is so easy to play is because he automatically notifies you when an enemy champion is low. Make sure you're paying attention to when your blood scent activates so you can look at the map, see where that enemy champion is, and determine whether or not it's worth ganking. Remember, Warwick thrives off of chasing a single target down who's already pretty low. This makes Warwick the ultimate janitor of League of Legends. Hecarim, on the other hand, is still really good at chasing down enemy champions, but he's better at teamfighting as opposed to chasing down singular targets. This is because of Hecarim's W specifically. Simply put, the more damage his team is dealing to enemy champions, the more health he's going to heal from his W. He can also fear an entire team with his ult if they are clumping too close together. He's great at diving through a team onto the backline and eliminating a backline carry before focusing the next one. Remember, his sustain through a fight is really good because of his W, so oftentimes you're going to be a frontline diver that isn't too at risk of dying themselves. A lot of assassins are going to be able to get onto the backline and kill them, but they might not be able to have the tools to soak damage or get out, but Hecarim can do both of these things. The hardest thing to learn on Hecarim is going to be his E's duration, but this is something that you will probably get down just by playing him in probably 5 to 10 games. Other than that, you just want to be mindful of when or how you are using your W. In a lot of cases, using your W while you are at full HP is going to be a waste because it doesn't deal all too much damage, and you're not going to be getting any healing if you're already full HP. Now, moving on to the mid lane, I'm sure you've already heard this plenty of times, but the mid laners you want to be playing this patch specifically that are really easy to pick up, but still strong, are going to be Malzahar and Annie. Now, there are definitely stronger picks in the mid lane, but these are going to take time to learn, and there isn't all that much time left in the season. Malzahar should be your go-to pick if your goal is to shut down the enemy mid laner. Malzahar has some of the best shove in the entire game. There are not very many champions that can match his shove. This means that he shuts down so many roaming opportunities that an enemy mid laner might have. On top of this, it's very hard to contest him for his shove or to even try to kill him because of his ultimate. Playing aggressive against the Malzahar is really scary because if his jungler is close by, all he has to do is press R on you and you're probably dead. He forces enemy carries to buy QSS, and depending on how many carries are on the enemy team, that could be as many as 4 QSSs potentially. Malzahar isn't great as a solo carry champion, but he's going to put his team ahead way more often than not. You should be seeing item advantages across the board, making it so that you have a much higher chance of winning any given game. Now, the other mid laner that you can be picking up this patch is Annie. If you follow LS, then I'm sure that you already know that LS preaches this champion religiously about how strong Annie is and how Annie should be the only champion that you play in order to climb the ladder. Now, I'm not going to go to this extent, but there is truth in what he says. Annie is very easy to play, and she's relatively strong, meaning you can very easily pick her up quickly and climb the ladder with her. The reason why Annie is so strong is because, first of all, she's very easy to farm with, but on top of that, she has a really good zone of control. Her abilities can't really be missed. All you do is walk up and Q somebody to guarantee the stun and then drop the rest of your abilities. There's not really much you can do to mess up Annie as long as you play it properly. She provides fantastic CC for her team, and a good flash Tibbers can just straight up end the game. With the recent changes to her E, her roaming and ganks are even better than they were, meaning she's good at laning, she's good at roaming, her team fighting is good. There really isn't too many downsides for this champion. The only major downside that we do need to cover is that she lacks late game wave clear, but that really isn't an issue in the majority of games, especially if you're ahead. Moving on to ADC, it's going to be a little bit different. You see, most ADCs share mechanics. They're all going to be very similar to play. For this reason, you can play any ADC, but if you're wanting to pick up a new ADC this patch, my recommendation is going to be Ashe. I don't really have another recommendation. Xayah and Kai'Sa are just as strong as they always have been the entire season, so if you're already playing those champions, then by all means, continue to do so. The reason why Ashe is going to be so simple to pick up compared to other ADCs is because her W is so easy to land in the laning phase. She's going to have guaranteed poke, her lane phase is going to be pretty dominant, and it's not going to be too hard for you to learn. On top of that, with Ashe, it's not just about mechanics and dealing damage. A lot of what Ashe has to offer is her utility. As long as you're throwing out your Hawkshot on cooldown to get vision of somewhere, and you're using your W in order to poke, and you're using your ultimate to lock down targets, you're going to be seeing some success with Ashe. Most other ADCs like Xayah and Kai'Sa can only offer damage, and that's just about it. With Ashe, you're able to help your team, so even if you're not ahead, you're going to be useful, and you have a chance of winning. Like I mentioned earlier before, if you just want damage and you're already playing Xayah and Kai'Sa, then by all means, continue to play those champions. Yeah, they got nerfed, but they're still some of the strongest ADCs in the entire game. Finally, we have support. Now, support is probably the hardest role to carry from, but it is also one of the easiest roles to pick up new champions on. My recommendation this patch is going to be Leona. Leona is a really good pick into most hard engage supports, and she still does relatively well into mages if you are seeing any of those bot lane, and she absolutely dominates any enchanter supports, save a few of them. She's also not that hard to learn, and because of the immense pressure she offers in the laning phase, most of the time you're going to be leaving lane with a lead, especially if you have an aggressive ADC like Lucian or Draven. Now, if tanky, aggressive, engage supports aren't your thing, then I would recommend Soraka. Soraka is really strong as an enchantress simply because she makes your ADC so hard to kill. When you combine all of the healing in her kit, plus runes on top of summoner spell heal, she can take an ADC from no HP all the way back to full HP with burst healing. On top of that, with her ultimate, she has global presence, meaning if you are paying attention to the health bars of your teammates, then you can save them in any event of a gank or a 1v1. She can play lane phase aggressive in a lot of cases, as long as you're not playing into a hard engage support or a hook champion. If you are playing against a super aggressive lane, however, say for example Blitzcrank and Lucian, then you can always just play back and just wait for your ADC to farm out, get some items, get some levels for yourself, and then you have a much better chance of surviving the lane or even winning a 2v2. The lane phase is probably the hardest aspect to learn on Soraka. Once you get into the mid game and late game, then all you're going to be doing is following your team around, healing them whenever they need health, putting down a silence if they need it in a team fight, and ulting in a team fight, and that's really it. One of the best parts about Soraka is that she uses Ocean Drake better than any other champion in the entire game. This is important because most people will just ignore Ocean Drake, and if you're Soraka, you should be pinging that Ocean Drake as much as possible. Ocean Drake turns you into a portable fountain. Now that does rely a bit on RNG. Obviously there's not going to be an Ocean Drake in every single game, but if there is, it's much more likely to go uncontested and then give you a much better chance of being able to get to that late game where you can just sit in siege, allowing Ocean to heal you up in the backline. Unfortunately, I don't really have any recommendations for you for mages as a support simply because they're going to take too long to learn. If you're already seeing success on a mage, then by all means, continue playing that. You don't need to swap what you're playing if you're already seeing success on it. And this goes for all roles. If you have a high win rate on a certain champion, then keep picking that champion. It means that you're going to climb with them. Now, that does just about do it for today's video on a few different champions that you can pick up for each role in order to climb during this end of season, these last 2 weeks. If you haven't already, make sure to check out our website, GameLeap.com. There we have hundreds of guides, all done by Challenger players, sorted into a quick and easy to use courses system. We have courses both on the five fundamental roles, as well as champion specific courses, so if that is something that interests you, then make sure to check us out using the link in the description below. If you are looking for a learning tool to help you improve, especially during this end of season, then I would definitely recommend our website as it is the best learning tool out there for you. If this sounds like something you'd like, then make sure to sign up today and start improving your play. As always, I'm Panther. I hope you learned something valuable, and I will see you in the next one.